Hello and welcome to this video about the best exercises for insertional Achilles tendinopathy following the Alfredson protocol as described in the year 1998. According to Silbernagel in the year 2020, those with insertional Achilles tendinopathy should limit the degree of ankle dorsiflexion to prevent compression of the tendon and the calcaneus, for example during uphill running or by placing a lift under the heel. Anatomical abnormalities such as the Haglund deformity may also contribute to pain, according to Silbernagel in the year 2020. The first exercise in this video is performed from an upright body position and standing with all body weight on the forefoot, ankle joint in plantar flexion, lifted by the non-injured leg. Then the calf muscle was loaded eccentrically by having the patient lower the heel with the knee straight. Keep in mind that these exercises are not performed on a stepper or stairway, but on a flat surface, limiting the degree of dorsiflexion in the ankle joint. The second exercise is performed just like the first exercise, but with both knees bent, concentrically loading the calf muscle with a non-injured leg and loading the injured calf by eccentrically lowering the heel with a knee bent. Again, no concentric loading was used to the injured calf, instead the non-injured leg was used to return to the starting position. When the eccentric loading exercises can be experienced without any minor pain or discomfort, extra weight can be added by using a backpack loaded with weights. This way, the eccentric calf muscle loading can be gradually increased. However, if very high weights are needed, the use of a weight machine can be more appropriate. According to the Alfredson protocol, these eccentric exercises should be done for 3 sets of 15 repetitions, 2 times a day, 7 days a week for a 12-week period. While performing these exercises, you may experience some form of pain. However, it is recommended to stop the exercise if the pain becomes disabling. According to the study by Silbernagel in the year 2020, insertional Achilles tendinopathy is often accompanied by additional conditions such as an enlargement of the bursa and calcifications. Keep in mind that if palpation causes a greater degree of pain anterior to the tendon than the tendon itself, posterior ankle impingement or osteogonium syndrome might be a more likely diagnosis. I hope you enjoyed this science-based video about the rehabilitation of insertional Achilles tendinopathy. For more information about mid-portion tendinopathy, make sure you click on this video next to me. And don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. For now, see you in my next video.